Good evening. 16 new cases tonight, but there is a silver lining. Most were in quarantine, not spreading COVID through the southeast. The strongest sign yet, lockdown could end as planned on Sunday. Our team is live with developing news as we fight this outbreak. Lane Calcutt leads this bulletin.
Everything about COVID and this lockdown is high stakes, and the numbers and the cards are falling the right way.
Where we received a range of very encouraging news for Queenslanders.
27 new cases, but 11 are on a tanker off Gladstone, being treated on board and of no concern. The other 16 were community transmissions.
The 16 locally acquired cases are all directly linked to the Indooroopilly outbreak. That brings our total number of cases in this outbreak to 79.
Three from Ironside State School, a teacher, and two students at Boys Grammar, 10 were close contacts.
So it's good, encouraging that all of the new cases again can be directly linked.
Good news too that four spent a total of only 5 days while infectious in the community.
And those 5 days all happened while we're in that lockdown, so there should have been minimal interaction. So this is excellent. They didn't come into contact with too many people.
Encouraging too, another record number of tests, adding to hope of the lockdown being lifted.
We did 52,351 tests, another record for Queensland.
Record testing, low community exposure, and Jeanette Young cautiously optimistic and hopeful.
No, I didn't. Expect us to be so far in front of the virus. This is fantastic news. We've still got a long way to go.
If the lockdown is lifted, if the doors are reopened and we are let loose, it'll be, she says, an extraordinary outcome.
If we get out of this on Sunday, it'll be the quickest response to any significant cluster anywhere.
And for that to happen, Dr. Young wants no one infectious to have been in the community and for the record testing to continue.
There are 7,766 in the southeast in home quarantine, locked away, doing it even tougher than the rest.
They are our first line of defence against this outbreak. They are doing a service to all Queenslanders. We all want to take care of you because you are taking care of us.
And again, a call to arms for everyone to do the right thing by everyone else. Stay home, get tested and get vaccinated. Lane Calcutt, Nine News.
Straight to Annie Puller now at East Brisbane. Annie, some positive signs then, but the situation with our schools is escalating.
It's changing on the hour, Andrew. A public health alert has been issued for here in East Brisbane tonight. The concern centres around Anglican Church Grammar School here, where potentially dozens of people have been exposed to infectious students during a rugby match. We're having some breaking news come to hand now that a second student at Brisbane Girls Grammar has tested positive to COVID-19. Nine News understands this particular student was in quarantine. She was let out on Monday and has spent 4 days infectious in the community. To put it into perspective, we are under a lockdown, so we don't know what that means yet for our list of exposure sites. Already we have venues surpassing 400, spanning 40 different suburbs, and many of them involve children. Doors shut in Ashgrove, deliveries abandoned. This is the grim reality for small business under COVID's chokehold.
It affects a lot of small businesses, both financially and emotionally.
The owners of the pet cafe here at Ashgrove simply can't catch a break. Lockdown has made it near impossible to pay rent. Now in the process of relocating, they're dealing with yet another blow. Staff out of action, potentially exposed to a COVID case.
We have 4 main staff members. 3 of them are currently unable to leave their home in hard lockdown until the 13th.
Our northwestern corridor is emerging as our new ground zero. 3 major supermarkets, Coles, Aldi and Woolworths, at neighbouring suburbs Ashgrove, Toowong and The Gap, are COVID exposure sites. And the list just keeps growing. 4 shops in Ashgrove visited by an infectious person last Friday. At Toowong, a dance school and fish market shut. Around The Gap, locals put on notice by police with a football field and club closed after a 12-year-old player contracted the Delta Delta strain, many accepting the unavoidable reality.
We'll just have to cope with it as best we can, and if everybody does the right thing, hopefully it will be contained.
I'm only going out for absolute essentials. I've held off the grocery shopping as long as I could this week.
The situation at our schools is going from bad to worse, with fears of further spread. At Brisbane Grammar School, the principal confirming to parents multiple students with COVID turned out to various sporting events over 3 days. Anyone who attended 2 rugby games played here at Anglican Church Grammar School on Saturday the 31st is now being considered close contacts.
So could everyone please check that you haven't been to one of those new exposure venues or one of the other exposure venues that are already on the site.
Exposure sites are now scattered across the southeast: Goma in South Brisbane, a church in Kenmore, UQ's aquatic centre, several suburban bus routes and a shopping centre in Shaler Park are now making up more than 400 venues.
Does it worry you that it...
Yes, it does. It does. People have got to do the right thing.
COVID-19 detection in wastewater gives us an indication of just how far this outbreak is spreading. Queensland Health sewage surveillance finding the virus in 16 suburbs, including the epicentre of Indooroopilly at Graceville, Rocklea, Kenmore and Enoggera. In the far north, 32 local areas in Cairns are affected. Annie Puller, Nine News.
And straight to Adam Hegarty now at 8 Mile Plains. Adam, how are the testing wait times tonight?
Well, Andrew, they're building here at 8 Mile Plains. I'll step aside for you to have a look. This is, of course, that 24-hour testing clinic set up by Queensland Ambulance to deal in the surge in demand for tests during this COVID scare and lockdown period. But there's an irony in that. The queues here are actually quite rare. They build at night, but during the day, there's hardly anyone here. It led to the Premier and Queensland Ambulance putting alerts out on social media today, alerting Queenslanders that if you need a test, coming here is probably a good first point of call, because chances are, if you go anywhere else, you're in for a longer wait. More than 50,000 tests for the second day in a row. There's only one way to put it.
A fantastic result.
Lockdowns thinned the work commute, but there's still a morning rush at Sullivan Nicolaides Bowen Hills Pathology HQ, a huge queue.
It hasn't been too bad. I've got 2 babies in the back, so I'm hoping it's pretty quick.
It could be quicker. The new 24-hour testing clinic at 8 Mile Plains deserted. Its workers ready, willing and waiting as thousands wait in traffic.
We've come down with colds, so we thought it's best just to come in and get checked and make sure we're all clear.
Just has to be done. Understand that there's a lot of people getting tested at the moment. Is what it is.
But perhaps most notably, many of the people in this queue haven't been to exposure venues. They simply feel sick and they're being extra cautious. That'll be music to the Chief Health Officer's ears.
This is excellent. The sooner we find you, the sooner we can block down any chain of transmission.
With another weapon in transit, vaccines. The Commonwealth to deliver Queensland's September Pfizer supply early. 112,320 doses, though it's still not for under 40s, and it's not here yet.
We've been advised that half of those vaccines will arrive next week, with the following half the following week.
For now, it's AstraZeneca, the state fast-tracking 22,600 doses to 113 southeast pharmacies, and that's from tomorrow. A rollout by name, but a crawl by nature. 119 more pharmacies still waiting for their first supplies.
In this current environment, it's better to have any vaccine than no vaccine.
And still on the vaccine rollout, there's been a rule during this lockdown period that walk-ins at community vaccination hubs have been banned. Everyone needs to go and book online first, and that stops queues. But it seems like behind the scenes, police have won the fight to not have that apply to them. We'll bring this letter up for you now. This is from the vaccine coordinator, also a deputy police commissioner to the police union. I'll read it to you. It says, I understand this has caused some confusion and concern amongst members. However, late yesterday and with some modifications to the operating models at the vaccination locations, this decision was reversed. The 11 LGAs in lockdown are now accepting priority workers on a walk-in basis where the hub has sufficient capacity and there are no queues or extended waiting times. Andrew, we should point out that applies to more people than just police. It's all frontline workers.
Okay, good to hear. Adam, thank you for that. Let's go to Peter Fegan. He's at Boondall tonight. Good evening to you, Peter. When will the drive-through drab start?
Well, Andrew, the federal government would like to see the hubs up and running by October. The Queensland government says while it's committed to ramping up Queensland's vaccine rollout, it would like to see more plans of this proposal before they commit. So where would these vaccine hubs likely be? Well, the RNA Showgrounds, the Boondall Entertainment Centre has been discussed, the Suncorp Stadium car park, supermarkets, the Bunnings parking lots, schools, churches and other places of worship, and drive-through options have also been discussed. And Andrew, the federal government went on record yet again today with a pledge: if you do want a jab before Christmas, you will get one. Andrew?
Let's see. Peter, thank you.